Hi folks, this is Bob Westerfield, and I'm one of the horticulturists with the University of Georgia Extension Service. I'm on the Griffin campus, and my filming buddy today is Miss Mackenzie English. She works with me as well as my horticulture program assistant. Today I want to talk to you a little bit about pruning muscadines. Now, muscadines are sort of the kudzu of the fruit plant. They're extremely aggressive, and they really should be pruned every season in order to get good fruiting. In fact, they fruit on new wood. That's wood that's going to come out this spring, all summer long, and it's going to put out a fruit or harvest towards the end of summer, very early fall. The time to do that then is during the dormant season. Anytime between really January through the very first part of March, before the leaves begin to come out, is when you want to get that pruning done. And today we're going to show you some of the tools and techniques on how to do that. Speaking of tools, you really want to have some quality equipment. Probably the number one thing you're going to use is some type of a hand pruner. Make sure you get a good one, one that can have replaceable parts, that can be sharpened. It's going to do the majority of the pruning on the smaller limbs. If you start going up in caliber on the limb size and have to take off something a little larger, then a lopping shears, which is basically kind of an overgrown hand clipper, will be more helpful and be able to tackle those branches that are probably approaching closer to 3/4 to 1 inch in size. If there's any super aggressive pruning where you have to take out an old stump or an old runner going down the line, you might even have to resort to something like a saw. A handsaw is handy. The little pocket folding ones are great as well. So here's a great example of a typical muscadine plant. And let me say this, when it comes to muscadines, oftentimes you want to have more than one variety, and that's due to pollination issues. Having more than one variety of muscadine, or even if it's a bunch grape, will help in the pollination and you'll get a better fruit set. Another thing's really important is you want to have a strong structure, something like 4x4 at a minimum post or large round fence post, and strong tensile wire to hold up that plant. It actually gets extremely heavy over the years as the caliber begins to increase and the weight from all the foliage and the fruit really begins to accelerate. Now what we have here is really just one main vine coming down the line, and all of this vigorous growth that you see is last year's growth. All of this came back from that pruning we did the following year. So this has to be removed so that we're kind of start that plant from scratch, and all of that new growth is what we talked about earlier, where the fruit will begin to form up from this year. So what you're going for on muscadines is you would like to have one strong central leader coming down the line, going out maybe two different directions depending on how you have your line set up. Now what we want to do is take off all this aggressive growth, and what you do is you look for these little side shoots, and we're going to kind of zoom in where you can see this. And we want to count about 3 buds out. So there's a bud right there. There's one. So right there, I'm going to make the cut, and I'm going to go just outside that bud. You see this little growing point here, and I'm going to make a nice cut just like that, and then take that away. All right, here's another one. We've got 1, 2, 3. If you go to 3 or 2 or 4, you know, life will go on. It won't be that big a deal. But want to make sure we don't go too far out. We want to really be aggressive on this pruning. So here's another cut. Get that one out of the way, and sometimes they get tangled up. It's kind of fun. Here's another one, 1, 2, 3, make a cut. And what we will do is we'll just continue to eliminate this until we really left with what looks like a bunch of stubs. And I know it looks almost contradictory to the way you would prune an ornamental plant, but that's what we're doing on muscadines. We're gonna do a really aggressive pruning, and from there, this thing will just bust out with new growth, and hopefully we're gonna get a fantastic crop late summer. It's a lot of work when you're pruning muscadine vines, but we have begun to, on this one vine, to kind of work our way down, and we'll just continue the process through the rest of our vines. But as you can see, it's kind of stubby looking. Also, something let me point out, if you can kind of zoom in, is oftentimes when you're pruning this time of the year, you're going to see some water coming out. Some people call it the vines are bleeding. But essentially what that is, that's just a wound response. It doesn't hurt the plant at all. And trust me, that'll harden up or dry up soon. And this plant, as soon as we get into some kind of consistent warm weather, it's gonna begin to flush out, and you're gonna have a whole nother plant again. This is our main trunk we talked about. It's the one we're preserving each year. And then we're, again, taking off the new growth that had fruit last year. This year, again, it's gonna fruit on that new wood that comes out. Hopefully you'll have a great harvest. Make jelly, do whatever you like, eat them fresh, and enjoy your muscadines.